Namaskar everyone. We were all looking forward to some kind of normalcy in our lives with this lockdown ending, maybe with some challenges. Then we hear this breaking news that the lockdown is continuing in India for 2 more weeks. In this situation, are there some amongst us who are feeling helpless, who are feeling that, you know, this situation is just not under our control? Do some of us feel that, you know, not just this, nothing seems to be in our control? So this COVID-19, the virus, the lockdown, government policies, what's happening with the economy, what is happening around us, sometimes we ourselves are not under our control. Interestingly, do you know that this helplessness also can be learnt? There are some people who, because of repeated failures in life or repeated negative circumstances in life, have learnt to be helpless. So even if when there are opportunities, even if when there are some ways out of this situation, one feels helpless totally, one feels that nothing is under one's control. Now this condition, it is called learned helplessness. So when one is in this kind of a situation, one feels that nothing is under one's control, one feels very negative towards the situation and after some time just stops trying. And this feeling is manifested as low self-esteem, as lack of motivation, as feeling that, you know, I'm good at nothing. Are you feeling totally helpless in this situation? Well, there are certain things which are not under our control, but it is a good idea to look around and see what are the things that are under our control. So maybe helping others out, maybe donating if that is possible for you. Maybe helping your family in their chores, maybe being more proactive in domestic chores, maybe indulging in your hobbies, art, music, exercise, whatever it is. Are there some things in your environment which are under your control? Well, since I have told you about this concept of learned helplessness, let me also tell you a way out of this situation. What is the opposite of feeling helpless? It is optimism. And when helplessness can be learned, even optimism can be learned. So let me share that insight with you. How can we learn to be more optimistic? The first thing is to embrace change. Now life is not static. Something or the other is always changing. And if we are too rigid and if we want to just stick to, you know, the way life is going at this moment of time, that is not going to happen. So the more we adapt to change, the more we embrace change, the better it is going to help us to adapt to it. Second thing is, when things seem out of control, it is a good idea to set some specific goals. Now it may not be a very big thing, but even smaller goals, and you strive for little goals so that you think that it is, you know, not all is out of your control. Once you reach that small goal, it is a good idea to celebrate that, however little it is, but some kind of celebration so that there is this kind of, you know, positivity and this kind of achievement, sense of achievement that yes, I set a goal and I managed to achieve it as well. We cannot make this situation the all in all of our lives, right? We have different things in our life. This is one of the situation. Yes, right now it looks very big and it is quite big. It is affecting us in a number of ways from a number of areas, yes. But it is not all in our lives, is it? There are other things in our life. Sometimes when things are not going the way we want and when it is very difficult, sometimes we become too harsh on ourselves. We become very critical, overcritical. Tell me something. Supposing your friend, your best friend was going through just the same situation that you are going through. Would you behave similarly with your best friend the way you are sometimes behaving with yourself? Would you use such harsh and critical language with your best friend? No. What would you tell your best friend? Probably you will say that, you know, this is a situation, it happens. I'm sure we can come out of it. So the way you talk to yourself, mind that language, mind the tone of that language. See if this is how you would treat your best friend. Coming back to our helplessness, if your friend were going through such a situation and feeling very helpless, what would you tell your friend? Would you just let him be or would you lift him up and tell him that, you know, this is just one thing in our life and we will be able to overcome this challenge? Well, I want to be that friend to myself for sure. With this thought, I wish you well. This is Jayashree Sarada from Roshni Counseling Center. Thank you.